All right, Chem Nation, today we're taking a look at the vacuum pump and doing some demos with that. The vacuum pump has an electric motor. There's a belt in here that runs a pump, a diaphragm pump. So when you turn it on, there's a hole in the top plate that we're sucking air through. And so when I put my finger over the hole, you can tell you're creating a vacuum. Okay, so I keep going.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So this is a bell jar. Okay, heavy glass jar that we're gonna set over top of this, and it seals on. So now when we turn the pump on, we're gonna be sucking air from the inside of the bell jar, and the pressure inside here is gonna be less than the pressure out here. So here we go. We have just a regular ordinary balloon in there. Our pump's not the fastest, but it's gradually reducing the pressure inside the bell jar. And hopefully you can see there's quite a volume change in the balloon. We may have the problem now that the balloon has fallen to the bottom and it's plugging the hole. And so we may not really be pulling any more air out, but hopefully you saw the volume change. Now watch this, I'm gonna turn the pump off and I'm gonna let the air back in. And when you let the air back in, then the pressure resumes to normal inside there and the balloon's back to original size. Okay, here we go with our second vacuum pump demo. This is Mike the Marshmallow Man, and we're going to place Mike inside the bell jar. Make sure it's sealed. Make sure everything's sealed up. We'll turn the pump on. Keep your eyes on Mike. See, Mike's getting a big head from all the extra attention he's getting right now. Okay, here we go. Now we're going to do the same thing. We're going to shut the pump off, release the pressure, or let the pressure back in. Okay, and now Mike the Marshmallow Man has become a shrunken head. All shriveled up. I wonder why a marshmallow would expand and then contract that dramatically with a pressure change. Here's Mike now, as he's shrunken head. All right, Chem Nation, here comes vacuum pump demo number 3. We're going to put some shaving cream inside the vacuum pump. Helps when you take the cap off. I am not endorsing Barbasol, by the way. It's just cheap. Okay, same thing. Hopefully you can see the very dramatic change in volume for our shaving cream. Even more dramatic than Marshmallow Man. I wonder why it is that shaving cream would expand so dramatically with a decrease in pressure. Pretty much fills the bell jar. Okay, here we go again. We're gonna let the air back in. That's kind of messy. That's what's left of your Barbasol. All right, Chem Nation, here is another vacuum pump demo. So what we have is a beaker of lukewarm water. I have a thermometer in here that's reading about 45 degrees, in case you don't believe me. Water is definitely not boiling. Okay, and so now we're going to put it into the vacuum pump and reduce the pressure and see what happens. This will take a minute to get going. Now at some point here, I'm starting to see some bubbles form in the water. And I don't know if you can see that yet in the video. But at some point, the water is going to be in a full boil. Okay, so right now the water is boiling like crazy simply because we have lowered the pressure inside. And you're not going to be able to see it in a minute because there's going to be so much evaporation. There'll be a lot of water vapor in there. The water's just boiling away like crazy. And so I'm going to shut the pump off and let the air back in. Okay, so number one, we have water boiling well below 100 degrees. And here's the other interesting thing. You recall the temperature originally was 45 degrees. And in that short time span, the temperature's now down to, it looks like, a little below 35 degrees. So in that short amount of time, the water lost at least 10 degrees of temperature as it was boiling. All right, here we go. Here's our last vacuum pump demo. What we're putting in there this time is known as tert-butyl alcohol. Okay, and this is a liquid that will boil like water, but at a temperature much closer to room temperature. So this is at room temperature right now. It's around 25 degrees Celsius. And we'll turn the pump on. So sort of like the water, the pressure's going down inside, and eventually here we'll start to see some bubbles form in the tert-butyl alcohol. And eventually here it should start to boil, much as the water did. Okay, I'm starting to see some bubbles now, so keep your eyes on it. When this next thing that happens quick. Okay, so we're getting some boiling, we're getting some bubbles to form. Okay, so now the tert-butyl alcohol is in full boil. Keep your eyes on it. Here we go. Look at this. Tert-butyl alcohol is boiling, and now it is in the process of freezing. It's becoming a solid. Okay, so as this liquid's boiling, it is now converting over to a solid. So you literally have all three phases present. You've got liquid, gas, and solid all at once. Go look up triple point, see what you find. Okay, here's the tert-butyl alcohol close up and is definitely much more solid than it was when it went in.